What's going on, guys? I've got here a 2004 Nissan Maxima, and I'm using this car to point out to you the location of all of the different fuses for your windshield wipers and your windshield washer. So we're gonna find these under the hood in two different locations. So the first fuse box we're gonna open into is this one right here. This one's quite simple to access. You just push in on this tab in the front and it will hinge upward. Now there's a 50 amp fuse that is actually integrated into a group of three fuses. So what we're looking at is this part of the fuse right here. This provides power to the body control module, which basically helps to control the behavior of the windshield wipers. So definitely something good to check out there. Now there are two additional fuses that we're gonna check in here. Now this is a little more challenging to get to. For one, there's this large cover that we've got to remove. There should be a number of clips throughout the cover. It's all broken on this car, so this just lifts up and out. Now we've got to deal with removing this. So it's retained with just a clip on either side. You can just pull it out. I've had good luck with just loosening the front clip and then kind of wiggling it. It'll pop out. And you can read about the fuses here, although I'll go ahead and show you what you need to look for. So there are fuses here. This is also a module. We can just barely see the fuses through the side. If you want to lift this up to get better access, then there are tabs that you can push in on either end. And then this whole piece kind of lifts up. Now the fuse for the windshield washer fluid is this 10 amp fuse right here. I'll go and pull it out just to show you what a good fuse looks like. Now the fuse for the actual wipers is this 20 amp fuse above it and to the right. So this provides power that's used for the actual windshield wiper motor. Now there are some relays involved, but they're integrated into this unit here. So there's no way we can swap those around or really even test them. But I'll give you some other troubleshooting steps here. A real common issue that I see, especially after a lot of ice accumulation, is one of the wiper arms will work and the other one won't. So a lot of times what happens, ice builds up on here, you turn your wipers on, and it actually will strip the wiper arm, or the nut in here will get loose. So let's say, for example, our driver's side wiper arm is not moving, but our passenger side one is. The thing to do in that situation is to remove this cover, which will expose a nut. You can check to see if this nut rotates when your wipers are turned on. And if it does, or if you see that the centerpiece is rotating, you can try positioning the wiper arm to match the angle of the other side, and then you can tighten that nut down. I believe this one is a 15 millimeter, possibly a 14 millimeter. If you tighten this all the way down and you see it rotating but the arm is still not moving, then it could be that the arm itself is stripped. Also, if this is tight and it's not rotating at all, but the other one is, you could have a problem with the wiper transmission, which is underneath this cover here. It's what the wiper motor is actually hooked up to. So yeah, I hope that this information was helpful for you. Please do let me know if you have any questions or any advice, and thanks for watching.